you're always gonna be making these. Certain amount of every year you're gonna get destroyed or messed up and.
Unless you buy those plastic ones that are all together, and I like the plastic ones. That was too hard to place the blue bottle.
You do like the plastic.
Yeah, I like the plastic.
I like it.
But now if you mix plastic with wood.
She's found Dave.
You got a one on top, it'll work on your two down here. Frame part, get above the water, that's, you got a one seat.
Don't put them together.
Oh, she's not gonna get any shorts.
Yeah, you had to wait for me and take forever, right?
That's okay.
Well, buddy, you've been coming to the meeting and everything, you know, I've been waiting to answer back all this.
That's only way I live.
You wanna do?
That's my thing today.
Grab one and put one in if you wanna put it in.
Because that's.
I have no problem with that.
I was scheduled to get the horse meat thing. I got a friend who goes, do that.
I said, as long as you're in bee business, you're gonna be making it.
You notice that?
Go there and turn the heat on. I turned it off so they could hear him scream.
Now, you can also put a little glue on the top of that frame.
When it's loaded too?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
He won't spread it for you.
Go there and do that. I'm gonna show you this way first. Okay, I'm not gonna hold those ones together. I'm going to use an air nailer. Nails that I buy. And these are not galvanized, but they're inside the house. I've got an air stick. Goes in just like that. Everybody know how to drive a nail, right?
You know how to smash your finger?
Yeah.
That's what you're going to do.
It's very good.
My glasses on. It's all blurry to me.
That tank's good while we get some people flogging it over.
Yeah, take that box off.
Oh my God, how large is
it? I don't know.
A little better.
A whole lot better. Everybody seen how I put them in with the nails?
Yeah.
You want to get the
oil off? 2 years ago, he
was. You're done with the hammer very easily.
What's the baby? Your fall. It's a chair right there.
Yeah, my foot hit it.
This is an inch and a quarter staple. This gun will shoot brads or staples. Like $23 at Harbor Freight.
Oh, wow.
Wait until you get your 20% coupon.
Yeah, always.
And you got her made. You need to go turn your air down, Joe. 80 pounds. Okay, that box, all those tops are done. Flip it over that way.
Second count. We got a field day or something coming up. Tracy, when's the field day?
2 weeks from today.
2 weeks from today?
At that 4-H camp.
Actually,
sand system.
You know, Greg Wines is calling me. Thursday. He said, what can I help you with? And I said, what are you talking about?
I don't think they're up or down on
Your name is on the papers right here.
And all the way outside.
Yeah, angle up.
I'll turn that around.
So. What goes up? That's so the foundation will slip in easier. I want that pointed in. Same angle?
Yes.
Going in.
Warren, you need to be over there. I won't get you.
It's the saw, how they cut it in there. It just makes a little groove. I'll put that on the inside.
Thank you for coming.
That'll make that foundation drop in there a little easier.
Feels a lot better in here. It does up there.
It's hard to raise these trees down here at all. Can't find it all the rest of it. It's hard to get it. Because here you got stuff to do. And get your clothes paper.
Where's
the
yellow rag?
You're right.
Tapped in real good. Beauty of this thing is I will here in a minute. You just got to learn to hold it straight up and down. One staple in the bottom. Once you get a staple gun, go turn your air down.
I did.
Turn it down some more. What do you got to
do? It's splitting them.
Right here. It's a little too much air on it right now for my seat, so I'm going to have him go turn it down a little bit. See how it's doing that to it? I don't like that, so I'll have him turn the air down. I mean, it's not hurt. There's nothing wrong. It'll be fine. But you can get away from doing that by simply turning the air pressure down. Now, I'm having him turn it down to 60.
So what do you have out there?
A little air compressor.
Now, why are you only putting one staple on this as a foundation?
Yeah, you should be able to drop your foundation right through. I wouldn't add any kind of jungle on it. Slow.
You're saying this is the bottom?
Yeah, this is the bottom.
So what keeps it from sliding out there? You seem like that would be the top.
Well, put it down there's there. A wedge on the top, and I'll show you how to put that in.
Okay.
On the foundation, there's a wire. Pop that wedge off, you put the wire down there, and then you staple the wedge back down on top of it.
Okay.
And that holds it in. But now they do have some that just have the groove there. You put it in there, and you take hot beeswax and run it along the edge, and that seals it in.
Yep.
And that's how I'm doing mine.
That's how they do that.
Now, why would you choose to do it that way?
I don't want the wire, because you can't cut it out with the wire in there.
If you want comb,
you can't have the wire.
Gotcha.
Oh, that's the bug. A little tighter. Still a little high, but we'll go from there. There, now that's the way I'd like to get them. These aren't bad. They'll work.
It's pretty much flush.
Yep, flush is what you want. Okay, now those are done. Oh, Teresa, he made that. You can hold that?
Oh, gosh. Yeah.
Okay.
That's why you put these in with screws.
Oh, yeah. That's really a good idea.
Now, see, the ones that I had, fixed it. These are a different...
That's a great idea. Make sure they're really tight. You can loosen it with a screw.
Now, you can check that with a screw, with the square.
She's so bad, right?
And see if they're square. You shouldn't have to do this. If you make one and you buy your frames from the same person each time, you make it to fit your frames, it should be okay. How square are we?
I think we're pretty square.
Yep.
That's what I want to know.